So in this video, I'm going to review the blood flow of the heart, but rather than just explain it, I'm going to ask a series of questions to kind of guide you through it so that you can take note of the things you already know versus what you still need to work on. If you prefer just to hear me explain it, check the description for a link because I do have a video like that as well. All right, so looking at the front of the heart, what is this vessel, and this vessel? So this is the superior vena cava, aorta, and pulmonary trunk artery, so SAP. Which of those vessels are exits, meaning that they carry blood away from the heart? So the aorta and the pulmonary trunk artery are both exits. Remember, arteries carry blood away from the heart, veins bring blood back to the heart. So the blood that is entering the aorta, what chamber did it just come out of? That would be the left ventricle. And the blood entering the pulmonary trunk just came out of the right ventricle. So the ventricles are the open spaces that have muscular walls. They're going to pump the blood up and out of the heart. What do we call the empty spaces inside the heart through which the blood is entering? What are the names of those chambers? So those are the atria. You have your right atria and your left atria. So we're going to start kind of like we're following a drop of blood coming into the right atria, and we're going to trace it through the heart and back to the heart. What are the three ways that blood could be getting into the right atria? It could come in through the superior vena cava, the inferior vena cava, or through this hole here, which is the opening of the coronary sinus. This here is the vessel, the coronary sinus. So the coronary sinus is just a vein that is carrying deoxygenated blood away from the myocardium, and then it enters directly back into the heart through the right atrium. All right, so once that deoxygenated blood enters the right atrium, where is it going to go next? So it is going to flow from the right atrium through this, which is the tricuspid valve, also called the right atrioventricular valve. And then the right ventricle is going to pump the blood up, and it's going to get through here, which is the pulmonary semilunar valve. And the pulmonary semilunar valve opens up and leads to the pulmonary trunk artery. Then the pulmonary trunk artery is going to divide. And there's two different ways the blood could go. It could either go through the left pulmonary artery or the right pulmonary artery, which is going to carry the blood to what organ? The lungs. Then in the lungs, what's going to happen? Carbon dioxide is going to exit the bloodstream and enter your lungs so you can breathe it out, and oxygen is going to enter the bloodstream. So the blood is going to become oxygenated. So the blood left the right ventricle through the pulmonary arteries. How does it get back to the heart? Through the pulmonary veins. And the pulmonary veins dump the blood into this, which is the left atria. Then the blood flows down through the bicuspid valve, It's also called the mitral valve or the left atrioventricular valve. Then the left ventricle contracts to pump the blood up and out through the aortic semilunar valve, which leads to this, which is the aorta. So there are two different circuits here. The right ventricle is pumping the blood through the pulmonary circuit, which is to the lungs and back. And then the left ventricle is pumping blood through the systemic circuit, which is to the body and back. And then there's kind of a little sub-circuit, because these two things coming right off the aorta, those are the beginnings of the right and left coronary arteries. Those coronary arteries are going to come out onto the surface of your heart and actually feed the heart muscle itself. And then that blood returns to the heart via this, which we said before, is the coronary sinus. So that circulation that just goes to the heart, that is the coronary circuit. All right, that's all the questions I have for you today. I hope it was helpful. Have a great day and have fun learning.